cheating soon-to-be ex-wife exposes herself after asking for open marriage. I'm done. Good. That's what we like to hear. She's asking for an open marriage. It's over. It's a wrap. Hey, True, longtime listener of the channel. I won't say that I am an everyday listener, though, but I found out about you in 2020, back when my current soon-to-be ex-wife and I had split and headed towards divorce. Oh. I found comfort in your channel and several others. The split started because we were having financial issues and I was getting fed up with her complaining. She also would complain about stupid things like me working from home and her not being able to. So I was fired from a company I'd worked for 7 years. It was a sales job and I was a team lead. I initially was laid off due to the pandemic. Everyone they laid off went back 2 months later. The thing is, the company was just afraid to have trouble and lose business because of the pandemic. But actually, they got much busier. They replaced me with a woman, though, and offered me to come back, but I was no longer team lead. There wasn't an explanation for it, but I later discovered from a previous HR that the woman accepted less money for the position. That really did suck, man. I did go back as there was no other options at the time in our small town. My soon-to-be ex-wife worked as well. Our life didn't completely become uprooted when I was demoted. But that's when her complaining began. And it didn't help that I started working from home while she had to leave every morning. She started treating me like a house husband, saying snarky comments like, "Why aren't the dishes done? You have the luxury to stay home," etc. I don't know if anyone else has experienced going from office to working from home, but the micromanagement was ridiculous, and I swear, it felt like they made our weekly goals more competitive and difficult to meet. And they complained when we did not meet them, saying that we all were slacking because we all now worked from home. The new woman who took my job, she quit. She couldn't handle it, not even a 2-week notice. The company begged me to take over the position. I was asking for the same pay I was getting before, and she, my higher up, tells me that we are not in a position to give raises in this economy. I said, well, I'll stay where I am. At least this position I could win all types of great gift cards and other perks for meeting weekly goals. That really ticked my higher up off. She was definitely out to get me now. They eventually found someone and I learned they paid this new woman even less money. Anyway, I'm now having to deal with a complaining wife and a crappy higher up at work during this time. One day, my wife comes home crying, saying, "I can't do this anymore. This is not fair." I said, "What now?" She says, "You get to sit at home all day. I hate going into the office. They won't let us work from home." I said, "Hun, I'm sorry, but trust me, I'm not just sitting here doing nothing. I'm on the phone all day, taking small breaks with only 30-minute lunches. Sometimes a call would go well past 5 p.m. when I was off." She went into the kitchen and started tossing crap around, saying, "Where's the food? I'm starving. There's effing nothing to eat." I reminded her that we agreed that we'd hit the grocery store tonight and eat takeout as well that night. She stomped to the bedroom, saying, "I've had it. I can't live like this." I go back and I ask, "So what, you want a divorce?" She says, "Maybe separation is best. I'm going to stay with my mom for a while. At least there I can get a cooked meal and don't have to worry about a house not being tidy." I said, "So for how long? What about our bills?" She told me to figure it out. I'm the man. She refuses to pay anything if she's not going to be staying here. What a depressed time, man. This was July of 2020. I paid everything, but honestly, I was scraping by. I started working weekends at a local Wendy's as a weekend manager. I worked all day long, but I had to do what I had to do, man. My soon-to-be ex-wife was gone until December of 2020. We'd talk and she'd say she wants to come home, but she just needed space. A few times I'd go to her mother's and we had sex, and sometimes she'd come back home and we'd get it in there too. But she didn't stay. I found your channel right before she came back home. The stories were everything to me, man. I found solace in hearing others go through things. Not that I was happy about it, but knowing I wasn't the only one just helped. She came back home in December of 2020, right before Christmas. Before listening to you, it never crossed my mind that she could have been cheating. I just simply wasn't even worried about it. I worked and paid my bills and took care of myself. Only after listening to your channel, I was asking her when she returned if she slept with anyone else. My soon-to-be ex-wife snapped. Are you kidding me? You think I would do something like that and continue to sleep with you? I would have filed for divorce instead. Wait, did you sleep with someone else? And you better not lie to me. That's what she said to me. I told her the truth. No, I didn't sleep with anyone else. Never even thought about it. She came back and everything seemed to go back to normal, especially since I was to start working back in the office again. January of 2021, things seemed to be back. Arguing stopped and us collectively caring for the home and cooking and both paying the bills came back. I quit my part-time management job and I can honestly say things seemed good. At that time, I stopped listening to your channel and only discovered the content again in October of this year. I remained subscribed, but I just didn't listen. Most of my recommendations on YouTube were AI technology, NASA, and space exploration videos. On Halloween, we attended a Halloween costume party, just like we do every year this past Halloween. She got so wasted, it was unbelievable. She never drank like this. She's never gotten this wasted. I was hanging out with the guys in the living room, playing Mortal Kombat, when I hear, "Woo, girl, go ahead." Something about that "woo, girl, go ahead" made me get up and see what was going on. It was mainly women in the kitchen drinking and singing. But when I went in there, there were a couple of guys in there also, whom I didn't even know. I haven't spoken to those two the entire party. When I walked in, one of the girls was kissing one of the other guys. My wife and I know this girl. She has a boyfriend. In fact, her boyfriend works as a manager at the Wendy's I went to work at. He's the one that got me the weekend gig when I needed it. He wasn't at the party for some reason this year, though. I said, "Becca, what are you doing?" The ladies all just started laughing, including my wife, and say it's just a game. We're playing truth or dare. I asked Becca, "Are you and Ronald broken up or something?" She says, "No." I'm sorry, call me a hater or a nosy Nancy, but I felt it was my duty to tell Ronald what I saw at the party, and that's what I planned on, and that's what I'd planned on doing. They asked me to join in on the truth or dare. Now everyone kept picking truth. There was one dare. Some girl flashed all of us at the table. It got to my wife, and I was up next after her, but I didn't get a chance to go. One of the guys I didn't know was asking my wife if she would ever consider an open marriage after she chose truth. My soon-to-be ex-wife smiles at this man, looking him in his eyes for at least 5 seconds before answering, and says, "Yes." Guys, I snatched my wife up so darn fast. I said, "Okay, we're done here. Time to go home." This dude, who I didn't know, jumps in my face and says, "Don't put your hands on her like that." I let go of my wife's arm. I threw one of the meanest uppercuts known to man. It kind of landed at the corner of his bottom jaw, but it landed good. This man fell back on the table. I grabbed my soon-to-be ex-wife, and we left. My wife cried in the car the whole ride home, saying she's sorry and that she's just drunk. I said, "You're very coherent. You know what you answered." She said, "Yes, I do. Don't you ever want to be with other people sometimes?" She says, "Why can't we have an open marriage? Just temporarily. It won't hurt anyone." I pulled over on the side of the road. It had just clicked in my head. She knew this guy that I just punished. I asked her, "Be straight up with me. Do you know that guy that was asking the question about the open marriage consideration? And have you ever slept with him?" She sat for about 10 seconds and said, "Yes." I said, "Yes, what?" She said, "Yes, I know him and we slept together." I effing knew it, man. I just knew it. I asked her when and how she met him. She said she met him on Tinder when we took a split. I said, "Split when?" She said, "In 2020, when I left to stay with my mom." I said, "Oh, so you were seeing someone that time when you said you wasn't. And you've known this guy for years. Are you still sleeping with him?" She says, "Yes, occasionally." I couldn't believe it. I wanted to put my hands on her, but I didn't. Next thing I know, police sirens are lit up behind us, and an officer approached my vehicle. The officer immediately saw my wife crying and was asking, "Ma'am, are you okay?" She said yes, but he called for backup. I told him we just left a party, my wife had a bit too much to drink, and we're headed home. He's asking me to give the usual license and registration. After asking my wife over and over again if she was okay, they eventually let us go. But what my wife said to me after we pulled off was insane. She said that she should have lied to the police and said that I hurt her, because I'm being unreasonable for not allowing her to open up the marriage. I told her she has effing lost her mind and she can't blame any of this on alcohol. She knows what she's saying and doing. Eventually, there was silence and she fell asleep. I wake her up when we got home and she passed out on the couch. My mind was made up to divorce my wife that night. There was no way, True. I found my divorce lawyer on November 7th. She was served the following week. She didn't think I was going for a divorce and tried to act as if everything was okay, even though she slept in the living room every night since the party. She didn't seem to care about that. When she was served at our home, she put her hands on me. I came in from work and she slapped me straight across the face. Then she started crying. "How could you do this to me? You're an evil person to do this during the holidays. What about Thanksgiving and Christmas?" I said, "So I was supposed to wait to divorce until the holidays were over? No way." She moved out November 17th. Last thing she said to me was that I will pay for this and karma is a B. That's where I am, True. Wish me luck on this divorce. I'll keep you posted. Wow, dude. Oh my God. You know, in my thoughts, and I know everybody's going to think this too, like, man, you should have left her back in 2020. You know, so many things were wrong. And it's like, you didn't know she was cheating or talking to some other guy. But the fact that she left you, okay, you guys, you hear on the internet all the time, "Oh, I don't do 50-50, or girls saying I'll never be in a 50-50 relationship, blah, 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 whatever. Most couples are 50-50. Most couple, and a lot of people don't even look at it that way. It's just, okay, we're together. We came together. We handle our home together. We handle things together. You know, what's mine is ours. What's his is ours. So a lot of people actually do think that way. So the fact that she comes home and says, "I'm going to go stay with my mom. And if I'm not living here, I'm not paying anything. You deal with it. You're a man." She bailed on you, dude. She walked out of your life. That's not just some, "We need a break," or I need a breather away from you. She walked out of your life right then and there. What if it was the other way around? you're both on a lease or whatever, you got the mortgage together, whatever it is. I'm assuming it's a rental lease or something. You say, I'm going to go stay with my mom. And she's like, I can't handle these bills by myself. I guarantee you she's going to be expecting you and demanding you to help pay your portion of the rent while she's letting somebody else come in and smash. You should have left then. But for some reason, you said it just wasn't in your head until you started listening to my channel and you heard all these stories and you ask her. I don't know why you thought she was going to tell you the truth. It's okay, man. I'm not beating up on you, dude. I was where you were too, man. I was this type of guy. I didn't even think that she was cheating on me. I just would not have thought about it. And just never crossed my mind. You know, and I started reading stories online and stuff like that and picking up on signs, you know? So I'm not gonna beat you up, man, but yeah. She was cheating. I'm glad you're divorcing her now. That guy, yeah, she definitely was sleeping with him. That was so obvious. She knew him. She's staring in his eyes. Yes, I'll have an open marriage with you. Absolutely. Oh my gosh. Guys, it sounds like he has another one coming. I'm looking forward to it, man. Let's check out another story. Me and my boyfriend moved into our place almost 3 years ago, and sometime last year, a new couple in their mid-30s moved in directly next door. Terrace, two-level houses, so we share a wall. We both have two upstairs bedrooms, and it quickly became apparent that they chose the room that shares a wall with our bedroom, as we would often hear them getting it in at night. No P-star level moaning or anything like that, but you can easily make out the movement of the bed and slapping of flesh on flesh, so enough to be a distraction. Oh, you guys should have competed. We both found it funny at first, but often they'd be at it in the very early hours of the morning, especially at weekends, and often multiple times back to back with breaks between. It really started to interrupt our sleeping, so we decided to just move rooms, and now our old bedroom is my work-from-home office. While they were both working from home and I was in my new office room, I'd still hear them at it during the day, every now and then, but I just put on my headphones and try to ignore it. No big deal, and good on them for having such an active sex life. Once the husband went back to the office working, I was no longer having to reach for my headphones nearly as often, so I thought that would be the end of it. A few weeks after him going back to work, however, the midday sex noises started up again, even more enthusiastic and frequent than before, which was odd, as her husband's car was not parked outside. I also noticed a pattern of hearing their doorbell go shortly before the sex started. Wow. Oh, she's one of those. After going nosy neighbor mode and peeking through our blinds almost every day, I noticed that a guy was parking in his van just up the road, popping in the next door for an hour of fun, then heading back out. Not only that, I've even spotted a different guy turning up every now and then. I've been cheated on before, albeit in a much more casual relationship when I was younger, and I think it's one of the most disrespectful and hurtful things someone can do to another person. It makes me so sad for her husband, and hearing her go at it with these guys on an almost daily basis is getting me increasingly annoyed and angry. My boyfriend says I just need to ignore it, and it's not worth getting caught up in these things. I kind of agree, but almost feel like making some kind of anonymous tip-off to let her husband know somehow. What do you guys think? P.S. She was already halfway through the second round with one of the guys this afternoon when I started typing this. Hey guys, thanks for the wide range of replies, everyone. For those saying mind my own business, I get that to an extent. But it kind of becomes my business when it's distracting me from work on a daily basis. There's been a few times I've had calls while it's been going on, and I just have to pray that the noise canceling from the mic is doing its job and be extra quick on the mute button when I'm not talking. A lot are saying to separate the two issues, which seems like good advice. After all, it's the noise that's impacting me personally. Even if it was with her husband, that would still be a major annoyance for me. In fact, even though we've moved rooms, we still hear them most nights and often early mornings too. I honestly don't know how she can manage so much sex. Admittedly, the cheating aspect, assuming it's not some kind of open relationship thing that they have going on, which seems unlikely, but yes, I suppose it is possible, is adding to my emotional response for sure. But ultimately, that's between them, not me. As much as I empathize with the husband, again, assuming he's unaware, I do agree with a lot of the comments here that it's not my place to out her and not worth being in any way involved with the potential fallout. My boyfriend also shares this view. Reporting to council, police just doesn't seem like an option. I mean, it is, but it would be obvious it was us who complained and neither of us want to go down that path. I think I will have to try to pluck up the courage and maybe try to bring it up casually the next time I see her on her own and hope for the best. On the bright side, their neighbor on the other side is an older guy who is practically deaf. So if they at least swapped rooms like we did, there's a less chance the other neighbor hearing them at it. Well, updates. Turns out, there was a twist after all. After all my moaning, my boyfriend talking to the guy out the back over the weekend, and as sensitively and politely as possible, brought up the subject of the noise as well. Long story short, they are adult content creators. Obviously, he never mentioned anything about the guy showing up, but we think it's probably safe to assume he's well aware. My husband was also very apologetic and admitted that they were both worried about the noise, but figured it must not be that bad as we've never mentioned anything all this time, and they tend not to hear much from us. It turns out the wife is now doing this as her main job and quit her previous job months ago, and they already planned on turning their spare room into their studio, which if happens should mean much less noise for us. Kudos to all of you that called me out for being so presumptuous and that she was cheating. Lesson learned, not to jump to conclusions. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Now, if it would have ended with her and her husband are adult stars or whatever, they have some OnlyFans or whatever, and they're doing their thing, I'll say, okay, whatever, that's their thing. Let them do it. But dude, it sounds like your wife is also a working woman, for a lady of the night type of woman. While you're at work, random guys just come up. Or maybe they're professionals. Maybe they're all professionals. But it sounds like people just coming over, you know, ringing the doorbell, smashing and leaving. I don't know. Maybe they have some freaky stuff set up for their OnlyFans. Yo, it's some wild couples out here, man. Oh, man. Look. Hey, if that's what they're into, that's what they're into. You know, but here's my thing. Before she even got to that last update, because that last one I just read, that was an update from her. People were saying, oh, mind your business. Stop doing this. Stop doing that. What if it was the guy and the wife was leaving? The wife was leaving and this woman's telling a story and everybody in the comments assumed, just like the person writing the story, yo, this husband is cheating on his wife while she's going to work. This is ridiculous. I feel like a lot of people would be like, tell the wife, she deserves to know, you know? I just feel like we get treated different. I mean, what do you guys think? You guys think I'm wrong about that? I feel like she would have ran over and told that woman.
Hey, when you go to work, your husband is cheating on you. He's sleeping with other women. I hear it every day. All day long. Women are just coming over. He's knocking them down. And then he knocks you down when you go home. But when it's the woman, oh, mind your business. You don't know what she's doing. You know, it's a little ridiculous if you ask me. But I'm interested to see what's going on in these comments. Let's check out the comments. Laughing, no porn star level moaning. That's what you think. Well, now that you mention you are pros, we don't think you're up to market standards. It's not noisy enough. Better work on that, mate. No, actually, that's good for the clientele they're servicing. The viewers, not the studs. Some people are turned off by the over-the-top screaming. It was amateur level moaning. Tend not to hear anything from us. Oh, burn. All right, you guys cracking jokes here. Let's see. I guess another premise will be nosy neighbor who comes over with a noise complaint. Adult content creators assuring there's always a happy ending and occasionally a happy ending. I do wonder why that other guy was surreptitiously parking up the street, though. Maybe it was just a convenient option for one reason or another, I guess. Yeah, that is interesting. I think she was a working woman. You guys know what I mean by that. A lady of the night. I think she was one of those types of women. And guys, there are some freaky people. There's some nasty people out here. Men and women. I'm calling all of you out. Y'all are some just nasty. I'm going to allow my wife to just get banged out by these random guys. Then I'm going to come home, probably not put on a Jimmy hat, and run through my wife all night long. Ugh. You guys are nasty. What is wrong with people, man? When's the last time y'all heard Jimmy hat? Yeah, I'm showing my age here. The Australian solution is to have retaliatory sex up against the adjoining wall and see if you can knock over any decorative beer bottles they might have on shelves. Well, yeah, that's when I was reading that. That's why I was like, well, why don't you guys just compete, you know? Let's see. Randomized bass speakers against that wall. It messes with their it messes with their rhythm and makes it really difficult to keep going. Now, that's funny. That's hilarious. You guys are funny in these comments. People are just making jokes. This is so funny. If it was his backyard, but the closest possible place to my buddy's window where he had his home office. My new neighbor introduced himself to me a couple of months ago and mentioned he has to get up in the wee hours of the morning for work and hoped he wasn't disturbing me getting ready. I told him that the noise from previous tenants never really bothered me. I can hear it, but I'm a heavy sleeper. Mostly kids and dogs running around jumping on the bed, so don't worry about it. I swear he's doing construction up there all hours of the day, and I don't know how to approach him about it since I already said it was. I was sure it was fine. Yeah, see, what you should have said was, well, we'll see. I'll let you know if it bothers me, so you can come back and say, yeah, I don't know what you're doing up there, sir. Why are you hacking up your floor? Cutting joist and all. Stop, sir. Stop. Oh, man. Guys, let me know what you think about this story in the comments. This was funny. I enjoyed this. It had a twist to it. I was really expecting the wife to be a cheater. I wasn't expecting the husband to be a cuck. And that's what he is. But, I mean, look, if that's what some of you guys are into, so be it. You know, not my business. Guys, let me know what you think about this story in the comments. I'll catch you guys at the next one.